Well, the rain came down like nobody's business earlier here at the Shuang Lao Sports Centre Stadium, but Noah was not needed, and we are looking forward to bringing you the final instalment of athletic excellence here at the World University Games. And the first of the relay finals, the women's 4x100 metres of relay. Off we go then for the women's 4x100 metres relay. A huge cheer from the crowd and a great start from the Chinese athlete. It is Liang Zhaoqing who will pass on to Gay Mankey down that back straight. The Poles have actually got off to a relatively slow start. The Chinese are flying. Going well as well for South Africa is the 200-metre bronze medalist, Banale Shabangu. She hands on to Javale Mbisha. However, China still flying. China coming around looking to win this title for the first time in two decades. They have the baton. Is it safe? They're away. Down they come in the hands then of Li Yuting. Li Yuting comes away. China win the title. Poland take the silver and South Africa take the bronze. China turning the semi-final times on their head. The Indians not finishing. That's Shrivanka who's down. China with a fantastic performance right off the bat. The gold confirmed on the screen. Poland confirmed in second. South Africa in third. It's a new sets personal best for the Chinese, 43.7. Japan came home in fourth, losing out on the bronze medal by 0.3 seconds. But the Chinese take another gold this week, thanks to their quartet of Liang Zhaoqing, Gay Mankey, Kai Yanting and Li Yuting, who brought them home on the anchor leg. And the Chinese, out of the blocks, quick as a flash, already on the shoulders of the fancied Europeans. And the flashing... Well, I was going to say the flashing changes continued, but that wasn't the best changeover from Gay to Kai. Let's see what this one is like. Again, it's not magnificent. Oh, hello. Hello. Well, that will be interesting to see. Flailing around with the arm, and we wait to see here whether this result will stand. At the moment, no reason to think it won't. But a couple of rather indecisive changeovers from the Chinese. And by the time that Li Yuting got a firm grasp on that baton, he was dangerously close to the edge of the changeover zone. Once she got the baton in hand, she was away. No catching her. Celebrations at the moment for the Chinese. Well, you usually see that kind of routine when they're introduced, but why not do it when you've won? Well, at the moment, China confirmed as the winners in 43.7, half a second or so ahead of Poland in second place, and South Africa in third, and Japan in fourth. Poland take the silver medal, and it's a first bronze medal for South Africa. The men's 4x100 metres relay. So then Thailand in lane one. Lane two is Turkey, three the United States of America, four China, five Japan, six Poland, seven South Africa, and eight Chinese Taipei. It's a different Chinese quartet from the one that took silver 4 years ago in Naples. But they have gone off, but not as quickly as the men outside them. Poland with Łukasz Żak having a blinder and passing on to Łukasz Żak down the back straight. South Africa on the outside. The baton into the hands of Eckhard Pottgieter. China at the moment look like they've got the lead on the inside though. A magnificent race here by Thailand. Thailand coming away. And Thailand could take this. Here come the Chinese on the line. Thailand win it. China second. And South Africa third. Winning it from the inside. What a finish though. By Deng Xizhan. Hunting down the Dawachi Ahimeyad, and they've been given the verdict. A grandstand finish, he's just found out. And the quartet of Chen Jiepeng, Chen Gaofeng, Yan Haibing and Deng Xizhan. Goodness me, six thousandths of a second between them. Six thousandths. One of the closest results in history. Look at this from the Chinese on the dip. It's a Chinese double in the sprints relay. Well, the Chinese athletes have been getting headlines this week. Even more than some of the other sports, as athletics continues to be the headline act in our multi-event games. That was unreal. China didn't get the best start. But as they came in, they were still behind. It's a magnificent run on the inside. Looking at the changeovers, that's smooth. That was the change from Chen to Yan as he came round the bend. Now this one, important again. Hand out, not looking back. Pretty smooth, pretty good. Nevertheless, the Chinese were still behind at this stage. How on earth Thailand from the inside lane managed to get that far in front? But the increased speed here of Deng. Look at that. He wasn't in front until he leaned forward over the line. Marvellous finish. He's not exactly relaxed, is he, the Chinese, but he is fast. That is superb, and every time the crowd has seen that on the big screen, you can hear the roar as if they've won it all over again. That will be celebrated for years to come, that kind of finish, when you win on the line by six thousandths of a second. Confirmation then of China winning in 38.8, exactly the same time, bar a few thousandths there from Thailand. The unexpected challenges for gold, and South Africa take the bronze. The men's 5,000 metres. We have 16 men looking to come through and take the title that was won 4 years ago by Switzerland's Jonas Reiss ahead of Frenchman Jan Schröb. There's a Swiss and a Frenchman in the lineup today. So we screech our way into the final of the men's 5,000 metres final. And the man to watch in my eyes here is the man in yellow there at the back of that group on the left-hand side. The man from Uganda, Dismas Yeko, just 18 years old, from the Ndej University in Nararembe, in the capital Kampala on the north shore of Lake Victoria. He came through and took the gold medal in the 10,000 metres. He's a bit of a protege, to say the least, from a country that seems to be spitting them out for fun at the moment. The two Frenchmen have taken over the pace once more at the front. And we are heading into the last third of the race. We have still not really seen anybody really give it a go. They are still going along. They got a bit quicker for a while. They then backed off once more. You can see there the man who was fastest in the semi-finals, Nursultan Keneshbekov. from the Tokai University. The 23-year-old is now on the shoulder of the leader. The fastest man in the field, though, is the Japanese, Satoru Ishihara, who has gone 13.29, but significantly not been near to that this year. On the back of that pack is the South African, who has managed to attach himself again, Matthew Forrester, just 21 years old himself. He's in danger of being dropped again, but he's just taking it easy at the moment. They're beginning to wind it up, and it's Kinesh Bikov who's doing it. Bedar on the inside with the headband. Jaco moves out, goes past Frey. Kinesh Bikov is there, and now the move is coming. Bedar moving. Significant moves being made all around. The Finnish athlete is up there at the front as well. We haven't mentioned him yet. Emil Helander, 22 years old, from the University of Jyväskylä. Here we go then. 700 metres to go, and the sprint is on, and Bedar steps over the curb and is lucky not to turn his ankle over. He's back on again. He won't be suffering for that because it's down the straight. The Finnish athlete then, Helander, has put the hammer down. The 22-year-old is off, but look at that, Dismas Jaco covering that sprint. The two Frenchmen right behind. Then is the Algerian, Omar Seresh. Seresh having a good championships himself. Fifth in the steeplechase. Here they come then, up to the bell. Bedar will hit it in front. The Japanese is right behind him. All of a sudden, Dismas Jaco is fourth. Outside the medals at the moment is the 10,000 metres still in his legs. Bedar hits it, still going. The two Japanese are right there though. Ishihara and Yashihara. It's the four, the previous one who's there first, the 22-year-old from the Komazawa University, Taiwo Yashihara. He tries to come round the outside and may have cut inside of Bedar, who has to just clip his stride. Nursultan Kaveshnikov is also there, but away comes the Japanese. Has he got the legs to get to the line? The Frenchman is fighting. Bedar is coming. Can he get there? Yashihara to the line, and Bedar takes it on the line. Gold for France. Japanese silver. What a finish again. What a night of finishes we're having. The Japanese punches the ground in frustration. But France have the gold. France have never won this title before, but they have now. Look at this for a finish. The Japanese felt him coming, tightened up, couldn't get going again, and Bedar had the momentum. So then confirmation of Simon Bedar winning the 5,000 metres ahead of Taiyo Yashihara and Nursultan Kinesbekov. Dismas Jaco, the 10,000 champion, settling back to ninth in the end. Just too much in those legs. So France back on top of the podium with Francois Barrère. Also medals there for Japan and for Kyrgyzstan as well. We are down to the last two relays, the 4x400 meters, and we start off with the women. Four laps, four women taking one lap each. 1600 meters in all to decide who is going to be the World University Games champion here. Who will inherit the title from Ukraine, who beat Mexico and Australia 4 years ago in Italy? We've waited a long time for this relay. They run the first leg in lanes, and then they will break when they come to the end of the first curve of the second leg. And going out hard there on the outside is Boronika Bartanowska of Poland. Further inside is Regel Joseph of South Africa. She's racing in lane six at the moment. And inside her is the Algerian Jamia Zina. At the moment, The Chinese are a little way behind. They've been overtaken by Brazil with Marianne Silva de Santos, the silver medalist behind Alice Moraro of Italy. Italy don't have a team in this relay. Second leg then goes, and they will break when they get to the end of this bend. It's clearly going to be Poland in front. So good at relays. They're one of the best in Europe, and they are one of the best here at the moment. It is Karolina Lozowska, who was a finalist in the flat 400. She finished seventh in that, and she settles in. South Africa's Angelika Strydom, who was eighth in the flat 400, is running ahead of the Brazilian Lima Nonato, another finalist. The Chinese are coming further back. The Swiss girl is Veronica Van Carter, but she's just running out of pace now. But look at the strength of the pole at the front. So then, Lozowska hands over to Margarita Kazanova. And the Poles, if anything, have increased that lead. That was a really good run there on the second leg. South Africa into second place. Strong start there from Gazelle Macherman, sixth in the flat 400. Need to make sure you don't get too much in the first 200. It's very easy in the relays to be full of adrenaline and head off way too fast, and then the lactic acid kills you from here on in. And Macherman looks as though that might well be happening to her. The Swiss girl, Oksana Eschbacher, who was eighth in the 400 hurdles, looking a bit stronger as they come down the final straight. And the Brazilian is making up strides as well. That's Giovanna de Santos. Final leg then, Poland still out in front. It's Switzerland now in silver medal position, South Africa in the bronze medal position, and Brazil behind them. Now then, the South African going off really hard once more. This is the 400 meter champion, Marley Viljoen, herring around up on the shoulder of the Swiss girl, Karin Dijs, who was seventh in the hurdles race. Dijs has hung on to the back of her. The Brazilian anchor woman is the woman who was sixth in the 400 metres, Dani de Bassi. In they come then. There's no doubt about gold. It's going to be Poland. And the woman who missed out on a medal individually, Alexandra Formella, is going to come across. And what a finish by Brazil. Brazil are going to come through. And it's silver for the South Americans. Bronze for Switzerland. And South Africa are run out of it. Well, Poland back on top of the podium for the third time in the last four World University Games. After having their hegemony interrupted by Ukraine, they were only on the podium in Italy. But that is an emphatic victory, and what a race. It all turned around for the other medals inside the last 50 metres. One by Poland. Second Brazil, third Switzerland. Magnificent performance by the Swiss overtaking South Africa in what was a sensational finish between the Brazilians, the Swiss and the South Africans. But nobody could touch the Poles once again on top of the podium in this event. The men are coming out for the final event of this track and field program in Chengdu. The full lineup is Uganda, Burundi, South Africa, China, Turkey, Poland and Malaysia. The USA have the games record at the bottom of your screen there, but no American team in the 4x4 here in Chengdu. So it's Uganda, Burundi, South Africa, China, Turkey, Poland and Malaysia. And the Burundian side have got off to the slowest start on the inside. Godfrey Chanwengo has gone past him already. However, Poland already making ground. Adam Lukomski over there in lane 7 is being chased after, though, by Ilias Kanako, who was a silver medalist in the flat 400 metres, and the Turk has gone ahead already without the stagger. We can tell that they are going well, but the South Africans also thundering well. There is Halantla Maseko, sixth in the 400 metre final, and he hands over to Tjaart van der Walt, a semi-finalist in the 400 metres. South Africa have the lead. China are going well, though, as well. Zhu Huan, who is a semi-finalist himself in the flat 400, has handed over to Li Jingwang. Down the back straight then. And it's South Africa leading at the moment, but Turkey overtaking China, with Poland in fourth place at the moment. A little gap then, working back to the next man in line. Looks like Malaysia. China in third place at the moment. Poland have dropped back, which is a little bit surprising, but they're beginning to come through now. However, Turkey in front, South Africa second. South African. Van der Velde hands over to Wenlik van Rensburg. It's Turkey, though, out in front, with Ensu having handed over to the man who is fourth in the 400-meter hurdles, Berke Akam. This is looking good for Turkey, because they've got the man who was silver medalist in the 400-meter hurdles, Ismail Nezir, on the last leg. Turkey, then South Africa, Poland back in third place in a right ding-dong battle with the Chinese. Zi Jihu is third in the 400 hurdles. The bronze medalist is hunting down the European. And Mike Kokorim down the straight, the crowd rising. The South African is struggling, and he might be in fourth by the time they change over. Turkey lead. The baton in the hand of the man of Ismail Nezir. He's got a good 8-meter lead, and it's all to play for the other medals. South Africa being led off this time on the anchor leg by Luda Kaili Gora, eighth in the 400 metres. He might be losing ground, though. Here comes the Polish anchor man, the man who is fifth in the 400 metres. Maciej Remiziak, who is fifth in that final, behind João Ricardo Augusto Coelho, who won one of the tightest races ever in this event to win gold. Turkey, though, ahead. They are going to finish off a magnificent last day for them with a gold medal here in the relay. It's all battling now. Poland against South Africa. Poland holding on. Poland take the silver. South Africa the bronze. And China finish fourth. China were up there at the start, but they didn't really have the depth to be able to keep going, as well as Turkey did. And by the time that Berke Akam, who was fourth in the 400 hurdles, handed over to the man who finished second in that race, Ismail Nezir, they were already confidently in command. Great finish. It's been a wonderful week of university sport here inside the Schwenglau Athletic Stadium. Turkey confirmed with the win of 303.46. Poland in second, South Africa in third, beating China. So a wonderful end to a wonderful day for Turkey. They win the men's 4x400 metres relay. Poland in the silver position, and South Africa the bronze.